In this video, we're looking at the different file types involved with Stitchmastery, where to save them, and what to do if you need to set up Stitchmastery on a new computer or laptop. So first of all, I'm going to come to a folder where I have the software. So when I've downloaded the software from the Stitchmastery website, this folder, which probably I have named 3.1.0, I believe this will automatically just be called Stitchmastery, maybe called Stitchmastery Software. But the folder contains all of the different files that are needed to run the software. So we have the application itself, which runs the software. We have, for instance, the icon, which is our logo, and various other pieces that are all drawn together when you run the software. And as you can see, I have that saved in my external hard drive, so HD for hard drive. And I have it saved within a folder called Stitchmastery Software. Now, the reason for that is that I have versions of the software that are earlier to 3.1.0 in case I need to help support a customer who's still using an older version. So you wouldn't necessarily need to have this separate folder saying software if you're only having one version. When you download the software, you're given the choice to choose what location it is saved to. So if it was the case that you wanted to keep your older version and install the new version, get to grips with it before you delete the older version, then that's quite a sensible thing to do. And you can just make sure that you're saving them into separate locations. The reason that you need to be careful about doing this is that if you save your software into the same folder as the previous software version, the uninstall process will kick in and it may delete files that you already have saved there. That is also the reason that we always suggest that you save your chart files, your stitch libraries, text templates and so on in a separate location so that if you have to upgrade, they're not going to get deleted by mistake. So I have a separate folder for my Stitchmastery charts, and at the moment that is actually saved on a separate pen drive just so that I control what you're seeing in this video. So if I open the folder, we've only got two chart files here. One is the backup file and the main chart itself, the knit2 file. So these are kept completely separate from my software, and of course being on a USB drive means they're separate to my computer's hard drive, so if anything should happen to my laptop, I've got these separate. We would always recommend that you save your files somewhere that is backed up, so either a separate pen drive, a separate hard drive, or in a folder that's backed up to Dropbox or Google Drive. There are lots of different online cloud storing solutions that you can use to make sure that you can access your charts from somewhere other than your main laptop or computer. So should something happen to it, then you have access to your files. And then I have a separate folder called Stitchmastery Files, and in this folder you can see I have a lot of different stitch libraries. So some are from older versions of the software and some are stitch libraries that other people have sent me. And there's also a folder here called New Laptop. Now that is probably, I can't quite remember for sure, but I believe that is what I've used as a namespace at some point. So if I open that folder, we'll see we have the metadata folder. That's automatically created by Stitchmastery and it's just another part of the way that the software needs to run. So it's saving information that it needs in a specific place that it knows where to access it. There's nothing really in there, plugins, you know, there's nothing here that I really know what to do with, but that's automatically created. It's nothing to worry about. It's just part of the gubbins of the software. And to return to the Stitchmastery Files folder, you may note that I only have stitch library files and I don't have text templates and so on. So if we come into Stitchmastery Tools, or if you're on a Mac, come to Stitchmastery right at the left-hand edge of the main menu and come to Preferences. Within the Stitchmastery drop-down, we have the style sheets and you can see that I do have a text template in my username, and in the description it says HANA templates used for generating text. So text templates, written style sheets and appearance preferences are actually saved within the software, but you can save them as separate files as well, and the way to do that is to export. So I've got Hannah K. Ross, text template selected, and I'll click export. And we're going to click export all because there's only the one selected. And I'm going to browse and save that again. So in the Stitchmastery files folder, add the name Hannah text template, click save, and then click finish. So if we click back onto our Stitchmastery files folder, we now have the separate file, so the EPF file. And of course, not only is this useful if you're backing up your files, but if you're working with a tech editor or perhaps working in collaboration with another designer and you want to share either your Stitch libraries or your text templates or appearance preferences, then you can email these files to each other or share them through whichever means of file sharing you are comfortable with using. So that's there as a separate file now as well. And finally, to come on to setting up the software on a new computer. So for instance, you've bought a new laptop and you are deciding that you're going to use that as your main laptop. So you do have the option that you can copy all of your files onto an external hard drive or Dropbox or whatever method you have available to you for transferring files and then transfer them onto the new device. And that's definitely what you need to do with your Stitch libraries and with your charts. You may find that you would prefer to just download the software, or maybe you're upgrading and you want to download the software from our website, and you can do that. The main thing to note is that when you do that, you will not find any settings that you have previously set up in your current version of the software. So the software is not linking back to our website or to an account online. Unlike, for instance, some apps, say on a phone, if you have to upgrade your phone and you find that your apps download again with all the settings as they were before, Stitchmastery is not set up in that way. So when you download the software from the website, you're downloading a fresh copy. So a bit like if you had a book and you'd written notes in it, and then you bought a new copy of the book, you won't then have the notes that you had previously written inside the book. It's a fresh copy. So be sure that you have your files saved and transfer them across. And to get them set up in the new version of the software, you may need to import some things. So for instance, with the style sheets, you see that we have the import option as well. So if I click import and then browse, find the right folder, so the Stitchmastery files folder, then I can select this file, the EPF file, and import that into my new software. Of course, I already have this file, so I don't need to import it now. So I'm just going to cancel that, cancel out. And Stitch libraries as well. We come to user version 3, and again, there's the import option. So I can then import the files, Stitch libraries that I have transferred across to the new machine, and then they will be available for me to use. So they're not being saved within the program, but the software has links to all the different folders that you've set up and have told it where to find things. So as you ask for it, it sends out a little signal to that specific location and finds the information that you need. Hopefully this all makes sense, but I will link to a previous blog post in the description box below, which goes into a little bit more detail. And please feel free to get in touch and ask if you're in any way uncertain.